Hello and welcome to Genius Academy. Welcome to the special session on Indian polity. For more clarification on polity matters, I will recommend you to bring M. Lakshmikant book on Indian polity, which was very much helpful. Also, you have to refer the newspaper, most essentially the Hindu, for regular updates, because it was very much vital to read the newspaper thoroughly and analysis and make a note from that, so that it might be helpful in your examination. Fine. So in today's topic, we are going to discuss about the pressure groups, which was constituted as pressure group, to whom we called as pressure groups in polity. The term pressure group originated in the USA. There might a question, the pressure group system has been emerged from where? It was USA. So a pressure group is a group of people who are organized actively for promoting or defending their common interest. They came together for promoting anything or defending their rights. It is so called as it attempts to bring a change in the public policy by exerting pressure on the government. It acts as a liaison between the government and its members. The pressure groups are also called interest groups or vested groups. There might be a question, who distinguishes between pressure groups and interest groups? There is no distinction, because these are same. The otherwise called as interest groups or vested groups. They are different from the political parties. They are not belong to any political party, in that they neither contest election nor try to capture political power, but they pressure the government from outside. They are concerned with specific programs, not generally, specific program and issues, and their activities are confined to the protection and promotion of the interest of the of their members by influencing the government. They try to pressurize the government so that their objectives will be satisfied. The pressure groups influence the policy making and policy implementation in the government through legal and legitimate methods, like both in policy making and policy implementation, like lobbying, correspondence, publicity, propagandizing, petitioning, public debating, maintaining contacts with their legislature, and so on. However, sometimes they resort to illegitimate and illegal methods, which are the strikes, violent activities and corruption. If there is a question, strike is a legitimate or illegitimate method, the correct answer will be illegitimate. Evenly violent activities and corruption are illegitimate activities. It largely damages the public interest and administrative integrity. So generally, pressure groups follow three different types of technique for securing their objectives. These are, they can try to place in public office persons who are favorably disposed towards the interest they seek to promote. And it was called as electioning, right? There might be a question, which process is called as electioning? Electioneering, when these groups they try to place in public office persons who are favorably disposed towards the interest they seek to promote. Secondly, they can try to persuade public officers whether they are initially favorably disposed towards them or not to adopt and enforce the policy that they think will prove most beneficial to their interest. This technique was called as lobbying. Take right. So there are three options. One is electioning. Then lobbying, then and the third, they can try to influence people, public opinion, and thereby gain an indirect influence over the government. Since the government in a democracy is substantially affected by public opinion, this technique may labeled as propagandizing. Fine. Three options: electioning, lobbying, and propagandizing. In this way, you have to remember, right? So, like many other democracies in the world, India has also largest democracy at the present time. So, it was very much vital for India to have pressure groups. So we have to discuss briefly about one by one. So a large number of pressure groups exist in India, but they are not developed to the same extent as in the US or Western countries like Britain, France, blah blah blah. The pressure groups in India can be broadly classified into the following categories. So there are a large number. Firstly, the business groups. The business groups include large number of industrial and commercial bodies like FICCI, Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry, and Indian Merchants Chamber of Bombay, like this ASSOCHAM. The full form is Associated Chamber of Commerce and Industry of India, and Federation of All India Food Grain Dealers Association, like this. All India Manufacturers Organization, like this. Then, this is the most important, the trade union. In case of industry, it was very much vital for the workers to have a trade union. The trade union is a tripartite body involving the employer, employee, as well as the government body. So it was majorly emphasized not only to protect the interest of the workers, but indirectly or directly it also protects the interest of the employers. So it was very much essential to have trade unions for an healthy environment in the organization. It is the trade union which determine the standard of living or wage of the workers in an industry. So I will read few lines one by one. For some, the trade unions voiced and demands of industrial workers, right? They are also known as labor groups. Trade union or labor groups. A peculiar feature of trade union in India is that they are associated either directly or indirectly with political parties. This was the thing. Political party. They are associated directly or indirectly. Some of the name of trade unions that are All India Trade Union Congress, which we applied to CPI, Indian National Trade Union Congress into applied to Congress, Hind Mazdoor Sabha is HMS applied to the socialist, then Center of Indian Trade Unions, that is C2, applied to CPM, Bharatiya Mazdoor Sangh, it applied to BJP, and then All India Central Council of Trade Unions, it was a CPI Marxist Leninist. Then All India Union, United Trade Union Center, like this, New Trade Union Initiative, Labour Progressive Federation, Trade Union Coordination, these are. And Bharatiya Kamgar Sena, belong to Shiv Sena, Hind Mazdoor Kisan Panchayat by Janata Dal United, like this. In many regions, these are known as very others name. So there might be a question, in which year the first trade union in India was constituted? The correct answer will be All India Trade Union Congress, that was AITUC, was founded in 1920 with Lala Lajpat Rai as its first president, right? 1920. Up to 1945, congressmen, socialist and communist worked in the AITUC, which was the Central Trade Union Organization of Workers of India. Subsequently, the trade union movement got split on political lines. Then the second group is the agrarian group. The agrarian group represents the farmers and the agricultural labor class. We know that India is an agricultural dominant country where nearly or more than 60% of its people have been engaged in the agricultural activity, which was called as primary sector or otherwise called as reproducing sector. So it was very much essential to protect their interest. Then to protect their interest, some of the agrarian groups have been represented. It was the agrarian struggle have been taken place whenever Gandhi went to Champaran. The Champaran Satyagraha was called as first civil disobedience movement by Gandhiji. It was done on 1917 at Bihar. Fine. So we are coming back. Some of the name of the agrarian groups are Bharatiya Kisan Union. It was under the leadership of Mahendra Singh Tikaiti in Wheat Belt of North India. Then AIK, that is All India Kisan Sabha. It is the oldest and the largest agrarian group. Then another group, Revolutionary Peasants Convention, Bharatiya Kisan Sangh, RV Sangham. It was then Shetkari Sangatna, Hind Kisan Panchayat, then All India Kisan Sammelan, United Kisan Sabha, etc. Then another group, the Professional Association. These are associations that raise the concern and demands of doctors, lawyers, journalists and teachers, which are noble professions. Fine. Despite various restrictions, these associations pressurized the government by various methods, including agitations, for improvement of their service condition. Although their primary objective is to serve the country and people, but they also agitate for their development of service conditions. It includes Indian Medical Association, that was IMA, Bar Council of India, then India Federation of Working Journalists, All India Federation of University and College Teachers, etc. Student organization. Student is considered as the tomorrow's future. So it was very much essential to skill them and provide them moral education. It was found that due to the political influence, the universities have been reeling and the quality of education have been deteriorating. In many times it was found that during the election time, especially in universities, there was large scale conflict and large disruption of the study. So the meritorious students have been largely affected due to this. For betterment of the Indian education system, it was very much essential to wipe out the election system in universities and to focus on the study only, and research also. Research was very much essential because it will help to innovate many new things which might be helpful for not only to the people but also on the long term for the whole country. And if we continue like this, we will surpass China in coming years and become the world leader. But we have to focus on that. So coming back to here, there are many student organization. I am just reading out some of them are. Akhil Bharatiya Vidyarthi Parishad, it was known as ABVP, then All India Students Federation, ASF, then NSUI, that is National Students Union of India, then Progressive Students Union, PSU, applied to CPM. Religions have been a major thing in Indian society. We found frequent clashes and vote propagation regarding the religious lines. But in 2017, the Honorable Supreme Court have been ruled that the candidates cannot propagate for vote in the lines of communal representation. It includes the religion of the candidates, religion of the enforcing body, also religion of the voters. So in here we are going to list out some of the major religious organization in India. These are RSS, Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh, then Vishwa Hindu Parishad, the Jamati Islami, Ittehad ul Muslimin, Anglo-Indian Association, Association of the Roman Catholics, All India Conference of Indian Christians, Parsi Central Association, Shiromani Akali Dal, etc. Then the caste group. During the later Vedic period, the caste system have been very much prevalent in the Indian subcontinent, and it was this Brahmanical system or Yajamani system which deteriorated the status of the so-called Shudras. Not only Shudras but many other groups have been largely affected at the present time. So at the present time, our government have been provide certain reservation to uplift this marginalized group, because historical, from the thousand years or many thousand years, they have been deprived of their rights and exploited largely. Even if the, for example, the manual scavenging, the upper strata will defecate at any place, but the Shudras will collect them and take in basket in their heads. So they are breaching the fundamental rights of these Shudras, and it was very much essential that we have to provide reservation to these marginalized groups, such as females, then scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, evenly the other backward castes, because only the Brahminism was at the top strata, which extracting all the benefits, starting from education to the wealth, land, everything. So it was very much essential that there should be reorganization of land selling, and to extract excess land from these Brahmins and to distribute among the Shudras or other groups. Evenly, the women's have been deprived of their right, and they have been made an inferior position to the male counterpart. So we are coming back to this session. So like religion, caste has been important factor in Indian politics, especially in the rural areas. The competitive politics in many states of Indian Union is in fact politics of caste rivalities. Brahmin versus non-Brahmin, then Rajput versus Jat, Kamma versus Reddy, Ahir versus Jat, Baniya Brahmin versus Pattidar, Kayasta versus Rajput, Nair versus Ijatha, and Lingayat versus Okalinga, like this. So some of the organization name is Nadar Caste Association in Tamil Nadu, Marwadi Association, Harijan Sevak Sangh, Kshatriya Mahasabha in Gujarat, Baniya Kul Kshatriya Sangam, Kayasta Sabha, etc. So due to the reservation, it was very much innovative fact. Due to the reservation, these groups have been certainly uplifted, especially in the urban areas. But if we went to the rural areas, there was large scale human rights violation of the Shudras, and Brahmins evenly dominant in villages. If you go to temples, for an example, the Sabarimalai temple, women's have been prevented from entering. Women's, especially the menstruating women's from the age group of 10 to 50, it was breaching their fundamental right. The menstruation part is the nature of the god for their filtration, but we are humans, we don't have any right to block them or interfere them in the order of nature. So we have to respect them. They are our mothers, our sisters, our wives, etc. So this was not maturity mindset of these groups who are preventing our mothers or sisters to entering from Sabarimalai or any other temple like this custom. There was a temple in Kerala also called Bhagavati temple. In that temple, the males in main getup are not allowed. They have to be in female getup. In Hindi, that was called as Sola Singa. The man have to be in proper woman getup, starting from makeup to the dress material of females only. Evenly, everything starting from wig to proper makeup. So men cannot enter the sanctum in male getup. He have to be in female getup. So this, like, so we have to respect them. We have to cooperate in every matter so that our economy will grow at a larger rate and there will be improvement in HDI, that was Human Development Index. Then going to the next organization, that are tribal organizations. The tribal organization are active in Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Bihar, Jharkhand, Odisha, West Bengal, etc. In Northeast state, Assam, Manipur, Nagaland and so on. Their demands range from reforms to that of secession from India, and some of them are involved in insurgency activity. The foreign power like the then East Pakistan, like the Bangladesh, even in our Northwest sector, Pakistan, China, Myanmar and many other countries persuade these tribal groups to secede from Indian territory. Evenly, the country of China was providing stapled visas to Arunachal Pradesh and Jammu Kashmir citizenship so that there will be no written record whether these peoples went to China or not. It was the order against the international community. So China have to be realized its fault and cooperate India in every matter, because from the ancient time India was a great country in solving many of the problems. So in this session, so we are listing out some of the tribal organization, some of the National Socialist Council of Nagaland, then Tribal National Volunteers in Tripura, then People's Liberation Army in Manipur, then All India Jharkhand, then Tribal Sangh of Assam, United Mizo Federation Organization. Then coming to linguist groups, I have to remind you, our Indian states have been reorganized in the basis of language, according to which commission? The Fazal Ali Commission. So language has been so important factor in Indian politics that it became the main basis for the reorganization of states. The language along with caste, religion and tribe have been responsible for the emergence of political parties, right? Political parties, they have been emerged during the on the line of language as well as pressure groups. Some of the linguistic groups are Tamil Sangh, Anjuman Tariki Urdu, Andhra Mahasabha, Hindi Sahitya Sammelan, Nagri Pracharni Sabha, Dakshin Bharat Hindi Prachar Sabha, etc. There are some groups who are founded on basics of ideology. Fine. Ideology was the new concept, like in more recent times, the pressure groups have formed to pursue a particular ideology, a cause, a principle or a program. These groups include the environmental protection group like Narmada Bachao Andolan, Chipko Movement, and then Democratic Rights Organization, Civil Liberties Association, etc. Women Rights Organization. It was called as modernization. What do you mean by westernization and modernization? Westernization, when we follow blindly to the practice of Europeans, their fooding habit, their dressing habit, etc. In case of modernization, we follow the good practice of the Western people. For an example, the democracy, women's rights, then child development, etc. Then there are some anomic groups. So anomic pressure group, Cyanamic pressure group have been associated in riots, demonstration, assassination, and like so on. The Indian government and bureaucratic elite, overwhelmed by the problem of economic development and scarcity of resources available to them, inevitably accused a technocratic and anti-political frame of mind. Particularly, demands of whatever kind are denied legitimacy. As a consequence, interest groups like groups are alienated from political system. Due to the alienation or marginalization, these groups formed. For an example, All India Sikh Students Federation, Navanirman Samiti of Gujarat, Naxalite groups, right, which was called as left-wing extremism group, which was very much radical and actively associated in assassination, bombing, etc. Then Jammu and Kashmir Liberation Front, All Assam Students Union, United Liberation Front of Assam, that was ULFA, Dal Khalsa in Punjab, etc. So these are some of the facts regarding the pressure groups in India, which are very much active in pressurizing the government and to change the policy of the government for the upliftment of these groups. So that's all. So if you like our initiative, then click on the subscribe button and press like there and click the bell option for daily updates. And share it among your friends so that they also can get the information whatever you are sharing to you. So that's all. Have a nice